Hi, I'm Gerald Zahorchak, and I'm the Secretary of Education for the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And in Pennsylvania, that means literally from pre-birth through our PhD system and our library systems. The idea, as we started framing the architecture for our plan to get to student results, intervention was obviously a critical, maybe the most important part of the work. So our staff, lots of leaders from around the state, started a response to the nation's call for RTI. And how do we really do intervention well? And as we started the work, it became clearer and clearer about the necessity of alignment, the necessity of using proven practices, and the assessment of good reporting and monitoring of a child's progress. So it began as we began to think about what we had in terms of initiatives going on. It fit perfectly in our framework, of course, that you're going to intervene for students who struggle. In Pennsylvania, we use RTII as our acronym. RTII is the response to instruction and intervention. So if you think of the model, we think of core instruction first. And do we get that right? Is there best teaching practices with built-in supports for students who would struggle? A way to understand, does every child in the room understand and make progress? So the first instructional level is why we added the second I. And we say it's first response to quality instruction. And then if there's a student who continues to struggle, of course, and there will be, you then link really well vertically the intervention. What tutoring or supports can we give to extend learning and beyond the normal instruction, the quality instruction that children get? How can we extend learning and provide a way to do quality tutoring, for example, our intervention, with data that's emerging constantly that feeds back in the loop for the intervention process, but also feeds back to the classroom teacher on how the teacher for that student can change instruction. So the intervention based and aligned with instruction, all aligned with our standards aligned systems. It's the state role to make sure that teachers are prepared that way, inducted that way, and supported that way. Principals are prepared and supported that way. Data systems flow into that. Everything we do builds that one system. Then it's the local community's role to discover the means. So learning communities start happening, best practices to get to those ends start happening. We know a lot of the right things. There's no one anywhere that would say the answer for a struggling student is an intervention. The answer for a struggling student from the Shepherd and Smith and other research is not to hold them back and do it again and get the same result or wait a year and see the regression occur again. The answer isn't just to promote them and say we're sorry you didn't do so well and we wish you well. The answer is make sure. Intervene. The responsibility starts at the very top of the systems. So we need to say, what kind of leadership do principals need in terms of understanding how to be the architect of standards-based systems, in terms of understanding how to use data and how to create operational plans, and mostly how to do instruction well and intervention well. So building capacity means building the ability of those people to lead and work in a context that's clear. We anticipate that we're going to, in new policy terms, link school improvement funds, the potential to partner us with us in initiatives like Race to the Top, linking those funding opportunities and support opportunities to making sure that they're doing the standard line system very well, and especially making sure they're doing the RTI model very well.